a missing person.
Okay. And how long have they been missing?
Nobody's heard from her since Monday.
Okay. Hang on one second, please, here. And where does this person live?
She got a daughter. She lives next door to Sober.
That's her address?
Right.
And her name?
Teresa. Alba.
Okay. And your name?
Karen. Alba.
Karen?
Karen.
Karen, T-E-R?
K-A-R.
Oh, Karen, I'm sorry.
That's right.
Okay, and what relationship is she to you?
My daughter.
Okay. And how old?
She's 25.
Okay, do you know where she was last seen?
She works for Auto Trader. They had gotten a fax from her on Monday at 10:31. They had faxed her today, but they don't know if she did. Got it or not, they haven't heard from her. And we haven't talked to her since Sunday. She was over here.
Okay, she works for Auto Trader.
And she also works for herself. She's a self-employed.
Is she married or anything?
No.
Just lives alone?
No, she has a roommate. He hasn't heard from her since Monday either.
His name?
Scott Bladon.
Do you know how to spell that?
B-L-O-E-T-O-R-N.
Okay. What is Teresa's middle name?
Marie.
And her date of birth?
3/22/80.
Okay. Your address? And you said
right.
And your phone number? Auto Trader got a fax from her at 10:31 a.m.
Right, I think. It could have been p.m. They didn't say. I had called Auto Trader, too. I think it was Monday morning.
Have you talked to Scott?
My husband did. He said he hasn't seen her since Monday. He was getting worried, too.
Where would have been the last place that we would have seen her on Monday?
At home, I guess. He saw her at home.
Does he have any idea, remember what she was wearing?
He didn't ask her that.
Okay. What's Scott's phone number?
He's at work. But I can give you the home phone.
2911.
Okay.
And he does live at...
Right. And he works for Jack Diedrich Construction.
Jack Diedrich?
Right.
Okay, does she have any medical conditions or anything? Anybody have any idea why she may not have returned home? Did they have an argument or anything?
We don't know. She doesn't have any medical conditions that we know of.
When does he get home from work?
Did he say when he's
going to get home from work? Okay. They'll want to go over there and talk to him, see once, you know, if they had an argument or anything that she maybe took off because she wanted to.
Yeah, they're not boyfriend, girlfriend or anything.
Oh, they're not?
No, they're not.
Okay. And last she was seen was at home. Do you know what she drives?
She drives a RAV4 Toyota. It's a dark green color, kind of.
Did you say red or dark green?
Dark green.
Ford Toyota?
It's a RAV4.
Oh, RAV. I thought you said red.
Yeah.
Okay, dark green RAV. Never heard of that.
Never.
RAV. Ford Toyota, dark green. You have any idea what the plate number might be?
No.
I didn't think so. Okay, it would be, do you know if it's listed to her or if there's any, it is.
Sheriff's Department, this is Lynn.
Lynn.
Hi, Andy.
Can you run Sam William Henry 582?
Okay, it shows that she's a missing person. It lists to Teresa Hallback.
Okay.
Okay, that's what you're looking for, Andy?
99 Toyota.
Yep.
Okay, thank you.
You're so welcome. Bye-bye.
Okay. What you're asking the dispatch is to run a plate that's Sam William Henry 582. Did I hear that correctly?
Yes, sir.
Sam William Henry would be SWH 582?
Yes.
This license plate?
Yes, sir.
And the dispatcher tells you that the plate comes back to a missing person or woman?
Yes, sir.
Teresa Hallback?
Yes, sir.
And then you tell the dispatcher, oh, 99 Toyota?
No, I thought she told me that.
Okay, it shows that she's a missing person, and it lists to Teresa Hallback.
Okay.
Okay, that's what you're looking for, Andy?
99 Toyota.
Yep.
Okay, thank you.
You're so welcome. Bye-bye.
Were you looking at these plates when you called them in?
No, sir.
Hi, Andy.
Can you run Sam William Henry 582?
Okay, it shows that she's a missing person, and it lists to Teresa Hallback.
Okay.
Okay, that's what you're looking for, Andy?
99 Toyota.
Yep.
Okay, thank you.
You're so welcome. Bye-bye. Teresa Hallback.
Okay.
Teresa Hallback.
Okay.
Teresa Hallback.
Okay.
Teresa Hallback.
Okay.
Hallback.
Lower lap. If you miss her very much, it's just very odd that you didn't hear from her for the last 2 days when she didn't return calls. Lower lap. If you miss her very much, it's just very odd that you didn't hear from her for the last 2 days when she didn't return calls.
What we understand, she made all three stops, and after the third stop is where she stopped answering the phone, or she stopped making calls. She hadn't listened to any voicemail messages after that. She didn't make any credit card transactions, so we don't know what happened after that. The grieving process, you know, could last days, could last weeks, could last years. You know, hopefully we find answers as soon as possible so we can, you know, begin to hopefully, you know, move on, hopefully with Teresa still in our life.
This is Action 2 News at 5, coverage you can count on.
Good evening. Thanks for joining us. The Calumet County Sheriff says the disappearance of Teresa Halbach remains a mystery tonight.
The 25-year-old was last seen Monday afternoon in Manitowoc County. Right now, police are conducting an aerial search of the land from Manitowoc to Green Bay. They're hoping to locate Teresa's car, which they say is a major key in their investigation. That car is a 1999 dark green Toyota RAV4, just like the one you see here.
Chilton, New Holstein, Kiel. But basically, we're looking at, you know, any public place, bars, restaurants, gas stations, grocery stores, post offices, banks, any place you can think of, any place that's going to allow you to put the posters up.
And if anybody knows, like, Manitowoc to Rivers kind of area, if you know it, that would be best to send you guys there.
If you do find anything, say find the truck, say you talk to somebody that has seen her or made contact or knows whereabouts or anything, don't touch anything. It's very important, I guess. Don't touch anything. Get a hold of either the detective or dispatch in Chilton and just, you know, tell them you're really concerned and you found this, and they can take care of getting a hold of who you need to.
I don't know what to hope. I don't know if you want to find a vehicle and, you know, she's there. I don't know if, you know, you want to find nothing and hope that she's somewhere still alive. You know, we don't know what to, I don't know what to hope.
Hey, kind of a change of plans here.
Okay.
The boss got something he wants us to do.
Okay.
He wants us to go back over and re-interview Avery again. And the search party is out there, and he wants to ask them if they would allow us to have the search party come on the property and go through the junkyard.
Okay.
So if it's okay with you, we'll meet you over at your sheriff's department.
Okay.
If you don't mind, help us out.
Yeah, that's fine. Step over.
Do you know Pam Sturm or her daughter, Nicole Sturm?
I had met them Saturday morning. They showed up after the good majority of everybody else had left, but that was the first time I'd met them.
What did you and Pam Sturm discuss?
She just basically came right out and said, has anybody went to the car yard yet, you know, the Avery salvage yard? And we just said no, that we hadn't been sending anybody in there, and she offered to and said she'd be willing to. And
before Pam left then to travel to the Avery salvage yard, was she provided a map or any other information?
Yes, I gave her a map.
What other information was she provided, if you know?
Scott had borrowed her his camera, just in case they were to find something.
You said that Scott had borrowed Pam Sturm a camera, is that right?
Yes.
But you mean lent, had lent her, given her a camera?
Yes.
A digital camera?
Yes.
He didn't give every one of those members Saturday morning a camera, did he?
No.
He just gave it to Pam Sturm, who he knew was going to go out to the Avery salvage yard.
That's correct.
It's the only person he gave a camera to, right?
Yes.
Ms. Sturm, were you familiar with the Avery salvage property?
No, I'm not. I wasn't at all. All I knew, it was a 40-acre plot salvage yard for vehicles.
Now, Ms. Sturm, prior to your arrival at that location, had you had any contact or direction from any law enforcement officials?
No, sir, we didn't.
Why don't you show us then? Where did you and Nicole start looking?
We had searched all of these. Then we went down here south, and there were, like, you can see there's two rows here. So I searched the first row, and my daughter was on the second row.
Let me stop you right there, Pam. Can you tell the jury what you were looking for?
We were looking for any trace of Teresa, be the car or herself.
Okay. And after looking at those rows of cars, where did you then look?
I continued up here, and I saw these vehicles up here, and this is like a ridge up here. So up on the top, there's a little car path, and you can see there's some vehicles here, and I thought, I have to search up there. I have to search each and every one.
And did you do that?
So I went up there, and I went through like three cars. And I went through like three cars, and I came upon this car that had all these branches on the top of it, leaning against it, and there was a old hood of a car leaning up against it, and it was kind of bluish green. And I thought, this is really strange. This is really strange. And it looked like a little SUV that, like, I was looking for, a RAV4 Toyota SUV. And I went around to the back of the vehicle, and again, there were branches leaning up against it, and I noticed that it said RAV4. Well, my heart started going, you know, oh my goodness, maybe this is it.
Let me stop you right there, Pam.
Sorry.
When you saw this, Ms. Sturm, what did you do?
I became very, very worried for our safety, because 90% this is probably Teresa's car, and we're in danger. So I called Nicole's name. I think I maybe even screamed. I shouldn't have, but I did. And I went running to the area where she was. I said, Nicole, Nicole, you have to come and see this car. It must be her car.
Did you attempt to verify the identification of this vehicle?
Yes.
And how was that done?
My daughter, Nicole, brought her cell phone along. And I should back up. Ryan gave us a direct line to Sheriff Poggle in case we found something. So I called Sheriff Poggle, and I said, I think I found the vehicle.
How long from when you entered that property did it take you to find Teresa's vehicle?
I believe we entered at 10 to 10. And by 10:20 to 10:25, we had found the vehicle.
Ms. Sturm, do you know how many vehicles are on this property?
I didn't at the time. I had no idea.
Looking at it now, do you think you got lucky?
Yeah. Well, not lucky. God showed us the way. I do believe that.
All right. Do you think, looking at this exhibit now, that you and your daughter, Nikki, could have searched that entire salvage yard?
We would have tried. We would have came back the next day if we had to.